Testing.
Good morning, everybody. I'm getting away from Charlotte. Well, I'm hoping I'm getting away from Charlotte. It's not. It's not out of boy, is it? That's okay, it's Emma. That's all right. We had a wee bit of an incident on Sunday. Sorry, on Saturday, where she instantly grabbed a boy's hand and started to kiss him. So, yeah, she may be going into the nunnery earlier than usual. You're very welcome on this, our Easter Sunday. It is wonderful to be together. Just some brief words of announcement. First of all, to say apologies, I'm not in my robes. And it's for a very practical reason. You will see during the address that there may be some mess. And quite frankly, it's a lot cheaper to dry clean a pair of trousers than to dry clean a cassock and surplice. So, apologies for that. It's purely pragmatic. In terms of announcements, I want to draw your attention to, I think, one, which is the Mothers Union visitors evening. Please do put that in your diary. It's on the 26th of April. Isn't the publicity lovely? Isn't it very impressive? Just thank you. And the speaker is Sarah Cole Coates from Women's Aid. Please do put that in your diary. It will prove to be an interesting evening, a good evening, as a sort of women from across the park and beyond. For everybody is welcome to come along. It would be great to hear the work of Women's Aid and to be physically together. Mothers Union is doing some really interesting stuff. It's been key in us starting up back many of our ministries after COVID, and it's been doing some great things as well, and outreaching into the community and developing links with those. And so please do put that in your diary and join them. If you can't remember it, you can tick the little flyers that are in your seat and pin them on the notice board. Just one other, two other notes. One to say, you will have seen it coming in, that there's no Together at 10 this coming week. And also to say a huge thank you for those who gave of their time yesterday morning to decorate the church. I want to thank Beth and her team for all the work they put in, giving up their Saturday morning to be with us. Saturday morning also saw our Easter time together. The Rectory Garden was a hive of activity. I want to thank those who made it happen, those who worked tirelessly in the kitchen, who braved the barbecue. Whether or not Stephen can see the amount of smoke that was in his eyes, but it was a great morning. However, if you didn't make it, don't worry. You haven't missed out. Well, you have missed out, but there is still a time to be together after the service this morning. The hall is set up with tea, coffee, tray bakes, and I really want to encourage you to take time after this service to be together. I was speaking there to Lindsay and Frank and Margaret, and I was saying how we had a lecturer at college who talked about church after church, being together after being together. And I want to encourage you to remain behind afterwards, over in the hall, for tea and coffee and buns. And they are particularly good buns. The fact that there's so few Rice Krispie buns left bears testimony. I can't look at chocolate anymore. But please do take the time to be together. We're going to take a few moments just to quietly still our hearts so that all that we hear are the voices of children. Christ is risen. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
In his great mercy, we have been born again into the living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
He has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places.
Christ is risen. This is the day when our Lord Jesus Christ was raised gloriously from the dead, crushing the power of sin and destroying the sting of death. Throughout the world, Christians celebrate the mighty power of God as Christ calls us out of darkness to share in his marvelous light. May we and all Christ's people shine as lights in the world to the glory of God the Father. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, banish all darkness from our hearts and minds. The light of Christ, thanks be to God. And we're going to celebrate that great truth in the words of our first hymn, hymn 271, Christ is risen today. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice, putting away all malice and evil, confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. Holy God, maker of all, have mercy on us. Jesus Christ, servant of the poor,
have mercy on us.
Holy Spirit, breath of life,
have mercy on us.
Before God, with the people of God, we confess to our brokenness, to the ways we wound our lives, the lives of others, and the life of the world. May God forgive us, Christ renew us, and the Spirit enable us to grow in love.
Amen.
Move among us, O God, give us life.
Let your people
Make our hearts clean within us. Give us the joy of your help. We stand to sing our next hymn, hymn number 64 in the Purple Thanks and Praise Books, In Christ Alone. Jesus Christ is risen from the dead.
Hallelujah.
He has defeated the power of death.
Hallelujah.
Jesus turns our sorrow into dancing.
Hallelujah.
He has the words of eternal life.
Hallelujah.
And I'm going to invite Jessica up to bring us our reading.
Today's reading is from Mark chapter 16, verses 1 to 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James, Salome, brought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter. He is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you. Trembling and bewildered, the woman went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were too afraid.
Thank you, Jessica. We're going to sing now the psalm allotted for today, Psalm 118, and we're going to sing it in the words of hymn 683, All People That on Earth Do Dwell. Here just to set up. You know it's going to be a messy one when I have to put down towels. Don't worry, they're clean ones. Okay, and if some of the young people want to come up, they may see better up here. No pressure, but you might want to avoid the splash zone. If any of the younger ones want to come up, Henry, don't sit on the, no, you don't want to sit on that. You want to avoid this area. Sit in
the splash zone.
You're in the splash zone there. So if you want to sit down just off the step, just before the step, no, where you are, you shepherd them all to where you are. You know it's a bad one whenever you have to do this. Well, we're going to pray. Thank you, God, for your word, the Bible. Help us to understand it and live according to it. Amen. That might be better up there. Is that better up here? Maybe not muffled under my apron. So, eggs. So, eggs, let's try that again. Okay, third time's a charm. So, eggs. Yeah! So, eggs. Eggs are great whenever they appear on the screen, aren't they? Eggs are Brilliant. Did anyone get any special eggs this morning? Any special eggs? Raina, did you get some special eggs? What type of eggs did you get? Chocolate eggs. Any particular type of flavour of chocolate egg? No, just generic chocolate. Just. Henry, what type of egg did you get?
A dinosaur and a city hill one.
A dinosaur and a marvellous one, yeah? And Freya, did you get an egg? What type of egg did you get? A chocolate egg, any type of chocolate? Just normal chocolate, not just, they haven't got the sophisticated palates yet, they're not. They haven't graduated, because we gave a, there was a, yeah? No, what type of egg?
Chocolate mini eggs.
Chocolate mini eggs. There you go, you know what, just, there you go. Have another one. Mason, what type of egg?
Freddy the Frog.
Freddy the Frog. There was a lots of eggs. Yes. Well, where? Oh, you've got lots of eggs waiting at your granny's house. And they're going to roll them down a hill. Oh, that's going to, oh.
Without breaking them.
Yeah, that's going to be brilliant. But eggs are great. We gave away lots of eggs. We had an egg hunt yesterday. We gave away lots of eggs. There was caramel eggs. There was Freddy eggs. There was M&M eggs. There was a white Terry's chocolate orange egg for the posh ones. There was a variety of different eggs. It was all, wait for it, excellent. I'm a dad now, I have to make dad jokes. Anyway, yes, this week I caught, this thing hits me. Yeah, there we go. This week I caught Charlotte climbing over one of these. And even though eggs are great, eggs are lots of fun, aren't they? Even though they're great fun, they can create a bit of a mess. Yeah, I have to wash my hands. Eggs can create a bit of a mess. You can crush them, you can break them. It causes an awful mess. And it causes, now you know why I'm not wearing robes. And it causes an awful mess because they're full of gloop. I'm stepping on one. I need to get my shoes polished. They're full of gloop, aren't they? They've got egg whites and they've got yolk in them. They're full of stuff. They're just full of gloop and it goes, well, everywhere, doesn't it? But this morning, and that's a bit of a surprise at times, isn't it? When we break an egg by accident, it can be a bit of a surprise because we're covered in mess. Well, this morning, I want to talk to you about a big surprise. I'm going to use it by using eggs. I'm going to tell you the Easter story by using eggs. Now, eggs are a big part of how we celebrate Easter, isn't it? Aren't they? That's there. We have Easter eggs. We roll eggs down the hill. But does anyone know where that comes from? Does anyone have any idea?
Chickens.
They're from, yes, eggs come from chickens, Henry. Yes. But can anyone tell me why we use Easter eggs and eggs to celebrate Easter? Anyone have any ideas?
Any
people? Yeah. Wilbur. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Any other ideas? Well, yeah. Harry.
Rolling down the well.
The rolling down the, yeah, but do we know why we roll them down?
Because you can paint them.
All right, okay. Well, one of the ideas is that eggs, oh look, this one's even still got the chicken leaf on it.
The chicken leaf.
Oh, chicken leaf. Well, one of the reasons is that people think that the egg looks like the stone in the tomb. Now, I'm going to tell the story of Easter using two eggs. We've got a big egg for the tomb, and we've got a little egg for
the rock
at the front.
two eggs. And I'm going to tell the story of Easter using the two eggs. So we're going to put on to the next slide, because when Jesus I need to hold it up, still the two. When Jesus died, there was a rush to bury him. So his friends didn't really get to prepare his body. They didn't get a chance to say goodbye, they didn't get a chance to wash it, they didn't get a chance to bury him properly. So they didn't get a chance to do everything they could. So as soon as they could, some of his friends, some ladies, went to the tomb to wash him, to prepare him properly. They headed off down the path early in the morning. But as they wandered down, they had a thought, and they panicked. They remembered that a huge rock had been rolled in front of the tomb to close it. And they thought, how are we going to get past that rock? Who's going to move the rock for us? And they spent the whole journey panicking. How are we going to get that rock moved? We saw that road. How are we going to do it? It took loads of men. We're not going to be able to do it. And they panicked. But when they got to the tomb, they found that the rock had been rolled away. It's the best bit of the talk. It was a huge surprise. The rock was gone. That rock that they'd worried about, that rock that they were panicking about, well, it had rolled away.
Somebody
rolled it away, Henry, that's right. But they got an even bigger surprise when they rushed to the tomb, leaned down, and they looked inside. And they leaned in, looking to see inside the tomb, and it was empty. Now, you're a wee bit surprised there. You expected to see egg yolks going everywhere. You expected the egg to be full of all the gloop, didn't you?
Yeah.
But the egg was empty. And that was the surprise. That was a big surprise. And just like that surprise of an empty egg, not first Easter, they found an empty tomb. That was an even bigger surprise. But there was an even bigger one yet to come. Because some angels came and told the ladies that not only was the tomb empty, the tomb was empty because Jesus wasn't dead anymore. He had risen. He was alive again. And that was the best surprise ever. Yes, Henry, the best surprise ever. Now, I'm going to send the children back to the seats, but we're just, as you go, we're going to keep talking about this. So if the kids want to go back to the seats, that's the messy bit over, so that, you know. But what made that such a surprise is that when people die, they stay dead. That's the way it is. When people die, they stay dead. Death seems so final for us. But Jesus didn't stay dead. Jesus rose again. He did something very, very special, boys and girls, mums and dads, and whoever you're here with. He did something very, very special. He defeated death. And that is the great claim of Easter. That Jesus conquered death. It's a claim that we hear from Paul in another part of the Bible called 1 Corinthians 15. Because there we read, Christ, the first fruits, then when he comes, those who belong to him. Then the end will come. He will hand over the kingdom of the Father after he has destroyed all dominion, authority, and power. He must reign until he has put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. Did you notice a special word at the beginning of that reading? First fruits. Now that's a phrase we don't really use anymore. It's a phrase we don't really use today, but it means the first produce of harvest. The first fruits of harvest. And that means that more will follow. The rest of the harvest is still to come. And so that surprise of the empty tomb is one that is important to each and every one of us. It reminds us that surprise of the empty tomb and the risen Jesus is one that we will all enjoy. It's a surprise that benefits all of us, because from those words, Paul tells us that Jesus defeated death for each and every one of us. And if we believe and trust in him, we will share in his victory. And we, like him, will rise again. Death will not hold us. And that gift of Easter, knowing that death has been defeated, and through believing and trusting in Jesus, we will share in that empty tomb. That's the great surprise of Easter. Let's pray. Dear God, Lord God, we thank you for the gift of Easter, for that surprise of the empty tomb and the risen Jesus. Help us to trust in him so that we will share in his victory. Amen. We're going to stand now to sing our next hymn, See What a Mortal. Trust in God the Father.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit? Sorry, the God, the Son.
I believe in the Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated as Lauren and Noah bring us our prayers.
Blessed are you, Lord God, by whose power our Lord Jesus is raised from the dead. In your presence is life and life eternal. In your power death is conquered and the gate to eternal life is opened. In your presence is the fullness of joy. Blessed are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Lord, make us aware of your risen presence in our lives. May our worship be full of joy and awe. Give us courage to go out to proclaim your love and give saving power. Lord, as we celebrate your resurrection, strengthen your church to tell the good news to the whole world. Bless all who are called to teach and preach in your name. In the power of the risen Lord, may we lead from darkness in this glorious light. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, as we rejoice in your risen presence, we pray that the world may know your peace. May we rise above division and strife, that your victory over darkness and death may be known in the world. Lord, show us the peace we should give, the peace we should share, and the peace we should forgo. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Risen Lord, you appeared to the two Marys and sent them to tell the disciples. Help us show your presence in our homes and in all our dealings. Let us walk in your presence and seek to reveal your glory in the world. As we ask you to bless our loved ones and friends and keep us ever in your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We remember all who walk in darkness and who are heavily burdened. We pray for all who have lost hope and who despair. We ask your blessing upon all who are chronically ill and those who can no longer cope on their own. We pray for all who are approaching death and their loved ones who are caring for them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
On the Easter Collect. Almighty God, through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, you have overcome death and opened to us the gates of everlasting life. Grant that, as by your grace going before us, you put into the minds good desires, so that your continual help, we may bring them to good effect. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we close our time of prayer in the words that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We're going to stand now to sing our offertory hymn, hymn 252, Alleluia, Alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Thank you. and the peace of the risen Christ keep you and be with you and all those whom you love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. We're going to sing our final hymn now, hymn 288, Thine Be the Glory. And all manner of calories. Thank you.